Hey folks. You are watching Movie in My Mind. Before we proceed, a little spoiler alert. Today, you are listening What Lies Below. Liberty Wells is really a 16-year-old high school student whom attends summertime camp frequently. While reading a book for a bench, a young boy requires a picture without her consent, causing her to shout at him and get Tommy's attention, whom she occurs to enjoy a crush on right after her mom Michelle picks her up. She tries to talk to her child, but Libby seems preoccupied with reading her book. Michelle turns regarding the radio to try and make Libby look, but she simply gets frustrated. She teases Libby about having a crush on Tommy, and she defensively denies it. Both of those have peaceful road journey back home. They stop halfway as Michelle allows her child drive the car. At first her mother is focused on her abilities, but Libby says she can manage to drive. As they drive, gradually she sees a on the market indication of their house and very nearly hits a tree. Her mother describes it's on her university training, as money runs tight at the moment. She asks in regards to the brand new bracelet that her mother is wearing too, which she replies that it is a present from someone. Finally, they arrive house properly. Michelle phone calls John, her new boyfriend, and Libby sees him the very first time. He gets from the lake to meet up her and give her a gift. She opens the box and views a bracelet with all the Navajo tribe stone of life. He explains the origin associated with the bracelet and chooses to give it to her because she loves archaeology. Libby gives a timid smile and expresses her appreciation in her space. She actively seeks an ensemble that she thinks would wow John. She sets for a blue gown and heads downstairs to say hi to John. While they prepare dinner, she takes a glimpse of him. While he reaches for something in the cupboard, Michelle notices that Libby dressed differently that evening and compliments her appearance. Out of interest, Libby asks the way the both of them came across. And her mother explains that for a typical time of composing regarding the porch, John just appeared. John explains that he is an aquatic geneticist. He could be section of a research team about freshwater animals and tries to resolve dilemmas in nature. He continues to demonstrate his research using two cups of water and ice as the two ladies pay attention attentively. She starts to feel drawn to John, finding by herself twirling her hair as he speaks similar to her mother. John coughs excessively after eating a piece of veggie. Michelle approaches him and hugs him after he apologizes. While they accept, he touches Libby on the shoulder and smiles at her. This provides her a strange and confusing feeling. She has trouble sleeping that night. Because John's touch bothers her so much, she goes downstairs to seize a glass or two through the refrigerator, but hears noises from her mom's bedroom, which seems like this woman is having intercourse with John. She requires a peek via a little space at the bottom of the door, but some body approaches, so she rushes back again to her room. This is why she also forgets to close her door. John passes by and requires a consider her while she pretends to sleep. The following day, Libby wakes up and finds her mom and John within the kitchen having a moment. She disturbs them by going into the space abruptly. Michelle informs her that the three of those may be happening a hike. She reminds her mom it is the 28th of August, a particular day for the both of them. And they should spend some time together. Rather, they both go outside. In a nearby tree, Libby digs a gap using a gardening shovel. She understands cans which can be labeled along with her nearest and dearest names. She pens a tin mite and slides a note inside after kissing it. She hands more than a tin can to her mom, but she doesn't place anything. Libby gets sad over this and tells her that Michelle never cared about anything. Every year Libby causes it to be a tradition to place letters in the cans meant for her relatives. Michelle explains that she stopped making letters because being a child she felt undesired in her family members. After their argument, Libby becomes quiet and decides to get a walk upon. Picking right on up a rock, a centipede crawls on her hand. She gets frightened by this and nearly steps about it. Simply with time, John prevents her by stating that it's a scolopendra, a unusual types of centipede. Libby informs him that it bit her, but John describes that it's simply trying to protect its offspring. As he lifts a piece of wood that reveals other centipedes hiding under it. She shows him the bite mark on her hand, and he blows it very carefully. He comforts her that she will be okay, despite the bite being venomous. They continue to share a conversation. While taking a walk in the nearby lake, John apologizes to Libby for disturbing their mother-daughter time and suggests that it would be better if he leaves. She disagrees, telling him that he should stay back at the house. Libby goes to her mother's room, who currently has a stomachache. She apologizes to her mother for her behavior. Earlier, Michelle apologizes as well for telling her too much information about their family problems. They both make up and forgive each other. Michelle also breaks big news to Libby. She and John are planning to get married. Libby says that she wants them to be happy, but she is obviously not thrilled about it. One issue is that John does not know Michelle's actual age. He thinks that she is 35 when she is actually 42. Libby researches more about Scolopendras, the type of centipede she saw earlier on her laptop. From her window, she sees John arrive at the house after jogging. She takes a peek at him removing his shirt and warming down after exercising. She lies down on her bed and sees the bracelet from John. She looks at it intently and decides to offer him a drink. She knocks on the basement store where John conducts his study and research. He does not respond, so she enters and sees the basement completely dark. John hears Libby and asks her to turn her flashlight off. She finally sees him holding a red light and offers him some soda. He respectfully declines, as sodium is bad for him, so he chores her to his workplace instead. Big aquariums fill the room. John keeps lampreys. These are an ancient extant lineage of jawless fish that have lived for millions of years. Lampreys are parasitic and can adapt to their hosts, and their survival rate is highly unmatched. He discusses more about the fish with Libby, who seems interested both in the topic and John. Libby asks about John's marriage proposal to her mother. He responds by saying that Michelle is very special to her and that they are very much happy together. Both of them plan on getting more samples from the lake, so they ride on an inflatable raft to go through the river. Libby asks John questions about his past as he paddles. He tries to reach for a cage he uses to get samples and asks Libby to hold his legs. While he stretches his arms, they talk about Libby's plans for college and how passionate she is in archaeology, when all of a sudden her period arrives. And blood seeps through the raft. John reacts quickly by covering it with his shirt. This frightens and embarrasses Libby, but John also apologizes for how he reacted. The situation grows extremely awkward and uncomfortable for Libby. Once they got home, Libby takes a shower and removes the bracelet that John gave her. He knocks and checks up on her, but she does not respond. Libby is starting to feel a weird vibe toward him. She does not mind his questions until she hears the door open. John enters the bathroom without Libby knowing. While she showers, John sniffs her from the shower curtain as if he is craving for her. Unsatisfied, he also sniffs the shirt that was used to cover Libby's blood in the raft. She senses that someone is inside the bathroom. She checks, but John makes his way out in time. She checks on her mother to see if she's feeling better, but John is currently massaging Michelle on the back. When she enters the room, John gives off an intense stare at her, so she closes the door. Libby tries to go to the basement, but it is locked. She tries to access it from outside the house, but all light sources are blocked and sealed. Worried that John is hiding something, she tries to contact her best friend Marley, but the reception is unstable. She tries talking to Marley using her laptop to invite her to come over. However, Marley says she is unable to go and asks if there is a problem. Libby writes back that her mom is marrying a freak of nature. Libby hears a knock on her door and finds out that John prepared a sandwich for her to make up for the awkward situation at the lake. That night, a red light wakes her up. She walks to her window to find its source. She sees John walking toward the red light coming from the lake. John submerges himself in the water and the light goes off. Libby panics and gets confused about what she saw. She tries to wake her mom up, but Michelle is unresponsive. She goes to the lake to investigate him about what she saw. He denies it by saying that he suffers from sleepwalking. Libby walks out unconvinced. The following day, Michelle calls her. She finds her mother in the bathroom throwing up. At this point, Michelle looks greatly unwell, so she asks Libby to drive to the pharmacy and get her some medicines in a pregnancy test. Libby suggests that they call an ambulance instead. Because she does not have a license yet, Libby asks where John is. He is out for his daily jogs and won't be back for at least an hour. Her mom experiences more pain, so she does not have a choice but to rush to town at the pharmacy. She sees John walk by with another woman. She follows them, but the cashier stops her as she forgot to pay. Libby gets home and sees Marley in the living room waiting for her. She heads directly to her mother to give her some medicine. John makes her extremely uncomfortable while she is in the room. Michelle continues to rest and John assures that she will be taken care of. Before leaving, John gives her a menacing smile. Marley tells Libby that he finds John hot and is thrilled to talk about him. Libby tells her what she saw last night at the lake. How John grabbed her and the uncomfortable things she experienced. Libby asks if Marley could stay the night, but she has an event to attend with her father. Marley gets furious after Libby's confessions. She tells her that she will let Michelle know that John is acting inappropriately. Libby tries to eavesdrop on the conversation, but she fails to hear anything. While waiting for Marley to come down, she falls asleep. Instead, she wakes up and heads to the living room. John and Michelle are watching clips of Libby when she was young. Michelle tells her that she actually is pregnant. This underwhelms Libby, and Michelle gets disappointed. Inside her response, she gets mad at Libby for constantly discovering negative reviews in regards to the guys that she dates. She calms down when John informs her that it is fine. As he hugs Michelle, he grins at Libby. His eyes deform and she pulls her mom far from him. Michelle slaps her daughter away from anger. As a result of this, Libby tells John the actual age of her mother. It disappoints John very much, causing him to go out the entranceway upon leaving. Michelle prevents him and their body gestures changes totally. The caretaker and child continue to argue in the living room. At same evening, Libby guards the house by remaining in the family room. After hearing thumping sounds from above, she goes outside to check on if one thing is on top. She encircles the home as she is extremely interested concerning the noises. She additionally looks on the lake for any signs of John and points the flashlight everywhere, but discovers absolutely nothing. Right back inside, she hears John and Michelle having intercourse within their room. She requires a peek inside and sees John's human anatomy deform as if one thing is under his epidermis. She goes to her space, walks back once again to check on them once more, but they are nowhere to be seen. Libby would go to the pond and discovers one thing in the water that looks just like a spaceship. She utilizes the car's light to take a better look at it, but she forgets setting it to park. Whenever she got out, this causes the car to be partly submerged in water. She turns regarding the light on a high beam and realizes it is really where the red light came from. It verifies her concept that John just isn't human. She tries to phone Marley for assistance, but here is a ringtone that appears to result from the basement. Due to the blue light, she is able to see symbols on her behalf wrist. It came from the bracelet that John offered. She views her mother tied with half her human anatomy submerged in a tank. She views the exact same symbols on her behalf mother's wrist. Additionally, the cellar walls. Michelle gains consciousness and freaks out. John comes down, but their feet look entirely like that of a various creature. Immediately he returns to his individual type. He checks on Michelle, who's demonstrably in great discomfort, and screeches within an alien-like manner. She offers birth from what is apparently a creature much like John. However, it doesn't survive, which devastates John, so he goes outside trying to revive the creature. Libby scratches a part of the screen to spy on John. She sees him transferring a blue light to the creature. Making use of their lips, she continues to try to untangle Michelle from the tank. Libby locks the doorway and hears the creature snarling away from cellar. She sees Marley's phone and dials 911 to ask for help. She views a tool that creates the sign never to work with their house. John attempts to speak with Libby so he might get in. He becomes more agitated and takes his real kind. She breaks the product while John smashes the screen using his hand. Libby is panicking and gets much more scared when she views Marley being eaten by lampreys. While hiding beneath the desk, John grabs and strangles her along. An animal-like tongue flicks out of his mouth, but she manages to fight straight back by pouring a bucket of salt on him. This seems to be John's weakness. She gets Michelle out of the tank. While John continues to be unconscious, Michelle apologizes to Libby for maybe not believing in her. As they attempt to escape and hightail it, her mother falls to your ground, causing them to decelerate. Somebody puts a case over Libby's mind, and she wakes up in an underground spot where she's tied. Clones of John begin appearing and smashing the room walls, revealing other dead systems. In tanks, Libby screams away from fear and agony, when one of the clones approach her a blue type of orb is transferred. To Libby from John's lips, she will not ingest it, but he forces her to do this, this knocks her unconscious. Once more, she wakes up with rashes all over her face and finds that this woman is caught in a diamond-shaped tank as well as other bodies. She becomes restless as she panics eventually, once the water fills the tank Libby smiles in a deranged